Hello beautiful Cancer, welcome to my channel Cancer Moon Oracles. My name is Rosa and I am coming in with a bonus extra love reading. I felt really called to bring this reading to you Cancer, especially off the back of going to my girlfriend's wedding yesterday, where I witnessed her marry her best friend. And it was a beautiful day of celebration. It was a beautiful day to celebrate love. It's raining here today and I kind of am in this lovey-dovey mood. So I thought it would be nice to bring in a love reading for you, Cancer. Okay, so we're going to go freestyle with this. It's just going to be whatever messages want to come through for you here today. Feel free to like, share, subscribe if this reading is resonating. I haven't worked with the Rider-Waite Tarot for a while, so I felt called to bring in the Rider-Waite. This video will be good for Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus Cancerian placements out there. To the cross watchers tuning in on a Cancerian in your life, feel free to take the messages as they best resonate, okay? You may be able to hear the rain in the background. I'm going to leave the door open because I feel like it's very cleansing and soothing. It's very overcast here today. Lucky for my girlfriend, she got the best weather yesterday. It was kind of overcast, but that's really great for photos, but at least the rain held off. Okay. You may have seen a little photo that I posted up on the community page also. And a big thank you to each and every one of you who continue to show your support, Cancer. It really does mean the world. For those who are new tuning into my channel, welcome. I do offer weekly love readings for all the zodiac signs with the intention to bring in bonus reads for the highest viewed signs, such as this video here today. And I would have to share with you, Cancer, that you would be the highest viewed sign on my channel at this stage. Okay, so we've got the Death card coming in. For some of you, you may be connecting to a Scorpio here. Okay, you may have recently ended something with a Scorpio, or a Scorpio may have ended something with you. It doesn't have to be Scorpio though. There's the Three of Cups, the Magician, and the Three of Wands in reverse. Let's take all these four cards. Let's see what's at the bottom. Eight of Swords in reverse. Cancer, I feel like with the Eight of Swords in reverse, you may have been stuck on somebody here, or there may have been a relationship here that held you back. And I feel with the Eight of Swords in reverse that you're freeing yourself from this situation or from this connection. Okay, you're freeing yourself from this situation or from this connection. Oh my goodness, look at that. Queen of Cups. Yeah. Bang on, Cancer. There's the Queen of Cups. This is water energy, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. I really do feel, Cancer, that you are freeing yourself from somebody here. With the Death card, you may have recently shut the door on a connection, because I feel with the Death card you're ready for renewal, you're ready for a rebirth, you're ready for new beginnings. I feel with the Four of Swords here, I feel like you've had some time to reflect on this. I don't feel like this was an overnight decision. I feel like you've been sitting on this for quite some time. For others of you, you may still be contemplating releasing yourself from somebody here. Okay, but this is what's currently going through your headspace. This is what's going through your mind. Yeah. Look at this. We've got the Ten of Cups in reverse. You may have seen yourself spending a lifetime with this person. But because the Ten of Cups is in reverse, I feel with the Four of Swords here, you're now seeing that it's not possible, or it can't be possible. Someone here who once made you very happy is leaving you emotionally dissatisfied or emotionally unfulfilled. Yeah. There's the Page of Pentacles. You may be dealing with an earth sign here, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. I feel like you were waiting for this person to offer you more, but they took their time. They took their time. It was very, very slow here because Pentacles energy is earth energy and earth is very slow moving. You've got the sun in reverse also, Cancer, which could be Leo energy here. But I feel this sun in reverse is distance. I feel like it's distance. I feel like there's a lack of warmth in this connection. And with each and every passing day, with the sun card in reverse, you're feeling less and less, or sorry, more and more. Oh no, what am I trying to say? You're feeling less optimistic about this Ten of Cups, the possibility of this Ten of Cups, because the Ten of Cups is in reverse. So you're not feeling hopeful regarding the future with this person. Yeah, I feel with the Temperance in reverse, could be Sagittarius here, but I feel that you're slowly losing your patience. And look at this, there's a star in reverse again. This is big Aquarian energy. Again, Cancer, I'm getting this notion that you're not feeling overly optimistic about your future with this person. And there's the Eight of Cups, right? There's you walking away. There's you walking away. I feel like this is an emotional decision for you. It hasn't been easy. I'm seeing the full moon here. This has been a challenging decision, or this has been an emotional decision. It's quite difficult. It's not easy for you to walk away here. Wow, that was a lot, wasn't it? Yeah, I feel with the Three of Wands here in reverse, this is you. You're no longer waiting for this person. Okay, you're no longer waiting for this person. I feel with the Three of Cups in reverse, I want to say that you might be cutting off like that friendship connection. I don't feel that you're keeping the friendship or that casual connection open. Because I feel like that would be very confusing if you did that. I feel like I'm speaking to a Cancerian here who is saying, I don't even want to be friends with this person. I don't want to be open to something casual with this person. Because I feel like it would bring too much, it would be messy. You know, I feel with the magician here, you're being brave and courageous. You're taking your power back. The magician is also self-mastery, Cancer. So you're mastering your emotions. Yeah, and I really like that for you. I really do. For those of you who have found it very difficult to detach or end a connection here with somebody, I feel like you are going to surprise yourself here with the magician energy. The magician would tell me here, Cancer, that you're ready for new beginnings. And it doesn't necessarily have to be you're ready for a new romantic relationship. You're just ready to step into your best self, you know? And the magician can also speak to trickery or maybe deception, where someone's just sort of deceiving you or being very manipulative here. But the magician is telling me here that you can see through it. Because the magician has tricks up his sleeve, you know? And it's like you would be able to see through this person's tricks. But overall, I'm getting here that you are coming into your power. You are coming into your confidence. And you're wanting to put a connection or a situation to bed, Cancer. Okay, let's see what's coming through. We've got the Justice in reverse. This is Major Arcana for Libra. Sorry, I've got the overhead light on, Cancer, because it's dark here today. So we've got the Justice in the reverse. This is Major Arcana for Libra. Now, Justice is in reverse, which tells me here that the situation is unfair. Okay, the situation is unfair, or the situation has been unbalanced for quite some time. You know, the scales are upside down, so this is not a balanced connection. You may feel that it's been very one-sided for you, Cancer. You may have felt here that this person that you are dealing with has not been reciprocating. And I do feel with the Death card here, you're ready to change things, okay? You're ready to change things up. You're ready to bring about changes for yourself. For some of you, I do want to say here with the Justice in reverse, you may be going through a separation, or you may decide, for those of you who are married or in a committed relationship, I want to say here with the Justice in reverse and the Death card, that a relationship or a marriage is over and you could be considering a divorce. I'm going to take the Three of Swords. Yeah, look at this. You've got the Ace of Swords. So this is your truth. This is you freeing yourself. There's the Page of Pentacles again. There's the Eight of Pentacles. There's the Hierophant in reverse. Yeah. Some of you, this is truth. Okay. Some of you, this is truth. You are going through a divorce or a separation. You no longer want to be in a commitment, or maybe this person that you're dealing with no longer wants to be in this commitment. Yeah, there's the Eight of Pentacles. I feel like you're just going to be using this time, Cancer, to really work on yourself. Okay, but even these two cards here, it's telling me here that you were dealing with someone who wasn't dedicated to the relationship, because there's the Page of Pentacles. This is like minimal effort, or slim effort. You know, this, it's telling me here that this person wasn't dedicated to the relationship. They just weren't invested in working on this relationship. Maybe due to a third party here. Okay, Cancer, maybe due to a third party. But there's the Three of Swords. We've got 333. So for some of you, there's strong third party energy here. But yeah, look, I feel like with the Three of Swords in general, Cancer, you don't want to hurt yourself anymore. You don't want to get your heart broken anymore. You don't want to be hurting anymore. You don't want to feel sad anymore. For some of you, I see a small portion of you Cancerians just, you know, shedding a lot of tears here, because you've really wanted something to work out. Okay. For some of you, I would say here that you and this person have been quarreling quite a lot. Yeah, but this is the conflict of the heart, you know, because you're looking for something more serious here. And this person was just treating this like as a casual connection. All right, let's see what else is coming through. We've got the Nine of Pentacles in reverse. Okay, let's just grab another card. Seven of Cups in reverse. What have we got at the bottom here? We've got the Moon in reverse, which is Major Arcana for Pisces. But I also see this as Cancerian energy. I feel with the Nine of Pentacles in reverse and the Moon in reverse, for some of you Cancerians, you've been really hard on yourself. You've been really down on yourself. I feel like I'm connecting to some Cancerians here with these two cards. As being unworthy, you may be comparing yourself to others at this time. You may be talking down to yourself. You might not be seeing your value or seeing your worth. You might be questioning yourself and thinking, you know, what's wrong with me? Am I not attractive enough? Am I not good enough? But I do see, like, you are all those things, because it's sitting underneath the Magician. You have all those things inside of you, whether you think you do or not. But I do see you trying to overcome maybe a lack of self-worth. This is you definitely being hard on yourself here. Three of Pentacles. Three of Pentacles could be working alongside others too, especially if you feel like you've been thinking very little of yourself. You may want to work with others to, like, pick you back up again, you know, to build you back up again, Cancer. For others of you, I see you as not wanting to invest your pentacles into this connection anymore. We've got the Seven of Cups in reverse. This is telling me here, Cancer, that you're not going to let this person treat you like an option. Okay, this is you. This is when it's in reverse like this, I'm hearing no, I will not be nobody's option. I'm not going to be anybody's option here. Because the Seven of Cups in the upright is saying options available to you. In reverse, it's telling me here you're not going to be anybody's option. You're not going to be this person's option. Or you're no longer an option for this person. Or you're not going to make yourself an option for this person. Does that make sense, Cancer? I hope I'm trying to explain myself. I'm trying to explain myself as best as I can. For others of you, this person had you emotionally confused for the longest time. And I see with the Three of Wands in reverse here, just above the Seven of Cups in reverse, that you're not going to put yourself in this situation. Or you don't want to be in this situation anymore. Okay. Let's quickly take a look at your person's energy. Can we do that, Cancer? I might come in with a different deck. I'm just going to give the cards a bit of a shuffle. Let's take a look at their energy very briefly here. Okay. Spirit, please show us the energy of the person that Cancer is dealing with and connecting to in love. Okay, look at them. They've got the Nine of Pentacles in reverse as well. So it appears that you have similar stories, Cancer. You know, I feel like this person is insecure within themselves as well. You know, the Nine of Pentacles in reverse is telling me here that this person isn't overly confident within themselves. Let's find out more, shall we? Tell us more. Wow, they've got the Death card too. This is big Scorpio energy here. Wow, so major endings here. You've got the Death card, they've got the Death card. Interesting. Tell us more. Spirit, tell us more about this person's energy. The Knight of Cups. You know what? I'm just going to grab one more card, Cancer. This is water energy, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. Just one more card for this person's energy, please, Spirit. Yeah, Four of Pentacles. Look, it would appear here, Cancer, that this person doesn't want to let you go, even though the Death card is here. they're feeling that things are over. Maybe you, like I said, maybe you ended things here, but this death card is speaking to ending. Something is over, something has ended. And this person appears to not be feeling very good about this ending. It feels like to me with the Four of Pentacles that this person is still holding on to the connection in some way. Or they're going to try to hold on. They're going to try, I want to say, reel you back in. Because the Knight of Cups is here. And the Knight of Cups to me is telling me that this person has romantic feelings for you. These romantic feelings could be inconsistent though, because this person is coming through as a knight. Now, I feel like this person is going to try to reel you back in, because I feel here with the Four of Pentacles, they don't want you to get away from them. They don't want you to get away from them. So with the Knight of Cups, I want to say that this person will try to be very charming with you, pleasant with you. They will want to say nice things. I feel like they will be very polite with you here. They may even come in with a message or an offer. But let's just clarify this Four of Pentacles, Spirit. Can we clarify this Four of Pentacles? I do have to say, though, with the Four of Pentacles, I do have to say that this person is guarded, or they are a little closed off around the heart chakra. Tell us more about this Four of Pentacles, Spirit. Tell us more about this Four of Pentacles for our Cancerians. Ace of Swords. So the Ace of Swords is new beginnings, you guys. I feel like there will be some new communication on the cards. I do. There's going to be some new communication on the cards. I feel like this person wants to talk to you. I feel like I want to say here that when they do communicate, they're going to be very indirect with their messages or their words. Because this sword is facing down. And in the background, there's clouds. So whatever they're about to say or whatever they're about to do, it may confuse you. Because to me, this is still telling me here that there's a lack of clarity. Let's clarify this Knight of Cups. The Empress in reverse. So you're the Empress energy, Cancer, and she's in reverse. You could be connecting to a Taurus here or a Libran. Again, I get a feeling that this person doesn't... I want to say that they have low self-esteem, or they're not feeling overly confident within themselves at this time. And I feel like it's because you have stopped nurturing the connection, or you have withdrawn that softer side of yourself. Let's clarify this death card. They want a new beginning here with you, Cancer. They know something's over here, or they know that something's ended. But I do feel that they would like to have a new beginning here. Like, this Ace of Cups may even be an incoming apology. Let's clarify this Nine of Pentacles in reverse. Yeah, look at this, the Magician in reverse. This person isn't able to pull the wool over your eyes, or they're not able to, I guess, manipulate you or deceive you like they have in the past. Because you're the Magician in the upright, they're the Magician in the reverse. Again, these two cards are telling me here this person lacks confidence. They're not feeling very good within themselves. They may be struggling to manifest something here with you. This person lacks the resources that you would need for a fulfilling relationship. So let's grab a last parting message or advice, Cancer. Sorry, my voice feels a little sore today. It was probably from all the laughing and singing and talking at the wedding yesterday. Okay, last parting messages for our Cancerians. Confidence is your key to success. I feel like this speaks to you, Cancer, but it also speaks to the person that you're dealing with, because they're the ones that lack the confidence. They're the ones with the low self-esteem. And I feel like it's because you're becoming more confident, or you're embracing your confidence, or you're mastering yourself here, and this person knows it. You could be connecting to a Leo here, so their pride could be getting a little in the way. We've got prosperity lies ahead. New moon in Taurus. So for some of you, you may be connecting to a Taurus here. But I feel this message is for you, Cancer, that, you know, good fortune or good luck or blessings like lay ahead of you. Okay, we're not looking behind us. We're not looking to the past. We're looking forward now. And I feel like this is that message for you, to look forward. So if you have needed that clarity, if you're the Cancerian here today that has been sort of meditating or thinking on moving forward with your life, then this card would be that sign for you that you need. So there's your messages, Cancer. Let me know in the comment section below how this reading best resonated for you. Let me know if I mentioned the sign of your person also, as it helps me to connect with your energy better for a more clearer and accurate read. And until next time, my Cancerian family, I will see you in my next video. Bye.